Hello, people. This is Christian. This is my computer and Fusion 460. In front of us, we have a Pokemon, the Gengar, I think it's pronounced, that I have turned into a piggy bank, so we can put our well-deserved earned little coins in here, and we have also for future spendings, we have a possibility to open the bottom and take out the coins again. It's really hard to get the coins out this way. Anyway, so this is Vadi. You can see I have a bit of a strange shell on the inside. We're going to have a look at that. So this starts as an STL. So I have a new design here that already saves. Going to insert the mesh. I'm going to make the mistake first. I'm going to simply insert. Hit OK. I'm going to do a convert. I'm going to quite fast. I did the faceted convert. And then I'm going to do a solid shell. I have this placed in my design shortcuts. Not that, but select the whole body. And do it 1 millimeter. And wait for fusion. And I can tell you we're going to get an error. Yes, we get an error. Fusion can't shell this solid, and it looks like it should be able to do it, but there might be some strange things. I've tried to do this by hand by doing face by face, and it gets a bit weird around like these facet or the vertex here where a lot of faces meet. All the faces are flat because they're triangular, and we want to keep this faceted feeling. That's the whole idea of a low poly design that this is. You want to have a low poly feeling when you 3D print it. So we're gonna delete these two steps and start over. Once again, I'm gonna insert mesh here, open, and I will now simply click the center because, yeah, you don't really need it, but I like to keep things center so I know where they are. Hit OK. You can see we have a region point in the center of the body. And what I'm going to do now is I will use the mesh commands or the mesh tools features. There's some shell commands here that's going to use. But before I do the shell, I want to know that this mesh has the right size for the future 3D print, because if I make the mesh the shell now and then scale it up, if it's too small, the shell is going to be too thick or too thin, and things going to happen. So step one, I want to make the mesh in a reasonable size for what I want. And the problem is, if I use the measure tool, I cannot find any points to connect on the measure, sorry for my pronunciation. But what we can do, we can right click here on the bodies, we right click on the mesh and we select properties. And here we have a lot of like area density, blah, 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 blah. And down here we have bounding box. If we click on that, we can see the length, the width and the height. And the height in this case is 51.7 millimeter. And my design intent for this is that it should be 150 millimeters in height. So let's do that up here. We have, if I don't have things in the same order of a toolbar, you can always find them. If I move it up here above modify, you can find it under here, or you can hit the S on the keyboard and start. We're going to do a scale. You can type in scale, start typing, you can find the commands. I move some things around in my toolbar to the way I like to have it. It's up to you. Always try to personalize or optimize the tools you're using. So we're going to scale mesh and select this mesh. It shows us the boundary box. Thank you. 1 point. Yeah, we can do it. And we're going to do, let's see, we can do a bit of a cheeky thing here. Can we do it like this? Will it scale it? Yes. There's a bit of thing. If I start typing in numbers in the scale here, now this is quite easy mesh, but you can see if I type in 15, it scales it up 15. But sometimes you can fool Fusion by starting with parentheses, start typing in 150. So 150 millimeters is the dimension I want, and right now it is 51.7, and end parenthesis, and it does the scaling. So by using the parenthesis tricks, you avoid Fusion starting to do the scaling. We can delete this and do it once again. If I type in something like 150, it pops it up to 150, and it does a lot of scaling. To fool it a bit, I'm going to cancel that. I'm going to do it again. Scale, select it. Start with the parentheses, start typing in 150 divided by 51.7. You can see Fusion is doing no calculation until I end the parentheses, and it does the scaling. I could of course also simply scale it times 3. It's approximately, I'm not that sensitive about a print like this, but anyway, I want to show you that. Click OK. So now we have made the mesh in the dimension I want to have it, and now we're gonna shell it within what do you call this, in the mesh workspace. We're going to do a shell mesh. I've already made, I'm going to delete this so you can see what I'm doing. I'm delete analysis. I'm going to section analysis so I can see how the mesh is going to look like this. So you can see the inside of a mesh. And I'm going to do now the shell of this mesh body. You can see here, I'm going to try and do the 1 millimeter first and then hit the preview and wait for Fusion to do a preview. And you can see the mesh here. And if you have a look, you can see it's poking through here and there. So this creates like, it tries to make the mesh the distance, I say, this thickness. But sometimes it has to do some compromises. So 1 millimeter will leave me with intersecting meshes, and I don't want that. So I'm going to change this to 2 millimeters and wait for Fusion to do some calculations and have a look. And I can't see anything of meshes poking through. And a 2 millimeter thick shell might be useful if you're going to put coins inside. If you make, you make it 3 millimeters, so if I try, if you make a thickness too much, the mesh might collapse and crash. Hit OK. We can turn off. The full body is still there. We are just looking at the section. We are cutting through to have a look at the body. So by doing this, we have now created a shelled mesh. Now we want to convert this. We're going to hit the convert mesh. Select our little Gengar mesh, parametric faceted. So this is the free version. You don't need the pay version for this. I don't need, think you need the pay version, at least either for this mesh shell and stuff. If you need, please leave a comment and tell me I'm wrong. I hit OK and let Fusion do some thinking. And we end up with a solid body that now has been shelled already. So you don't need to think about that. So that's nice. So let's do like this. Now it's a little bit stupid orientated. It's a bit down here, down below. I want to move it so it sits nicely on this ground plane, XY plane. And another thing, this is a very nice mesh. I think it's totally symmetric. It looks like the person creating this was very meticulous and did anything good. So I suspect that the bottom here is one flat face. Just due to how Fusion or STL files or mesh file works, it's been split into triangles. So what we can do and try, we can highlight one triangle and hit delete on the keyboard. You could also right click, we can do so. You can see it healed up. So I'm going to do this one, I'm going to right click and select delete. And I can do this one here, right click and delete. And by doing that, I have got one simple flat face down here. We can check if it's flat. We highlight it, right click, and see we can create a sketch. You can only create sketch on flat faces, nothing else. So we have a flat, nice bottom face here. So what we can do now, head over to the solid, do the modify, and let's find, I'm blind sometimes, use the align tool. I rarely use the align tool, basically only for things like this, if I want to move the mesh into a certain place, I know where it is. So I'm going to do align, turn this around, and move it over here. And you can see Fusion is nice and give us a lot of nice points to connect to. So I'm going to select here in the middle, and I'm going to move up. I'm going to hide the body for now and use this plane here until I find the icon pops up around the origin point, like that. Going to turn on the body because I think it's going to flip upside down, so I'm going to flip it like that and hit OK. I'll wait for Fusion to do some thinking. So this is just for me to get the model in a good place. It's now placed, so you can see by the alignment that in this what plane is it, the YZ plane, the one in here, is now aligned with the center of the body, so we can use that for some things like sketch and stuff like that. So what we're going to start with, shall we start with the coin slot? That's easy things. I'm going to do we really not need to do that, we can do the other way around. We create a sketch, hide the body. I'm going to create the sketch on this plane. I'm going to turn on the body, and I'm going to use what's known as the slice tool. So this is basically like a second analysis, but only in the sketch for now. And I will hit P for project. And I will project in two things. I want to project in this edge here. It's quite hard to see. If you turn off a slice, you can see it easily. I want this edge. And I want this edge. Sorry. P for project for that edge and that edge. And I hit OK. And I hide the body. So these two lines gonna do a look at, so it gets in the correct position, and F6 to put zoom correctly. I'm gonna mark all of this and turn it into construction geometry. So this point here is like the forehead of our little model. So I'm gonna make a rectangle, gonna change it into a 3-point rectangle. So I'm gonna make something like this, do a line, construction line from here to here. And I'm gonna make midpoint of this line to this here. So I'm gonna think of the slot positioned nicely. I'm gonna do one more line, still a construction line from endpoint here. This is like whatever design intent you want to use. I'm gonna use perpendicular and place the slot like that. And now it needs some dimensions. And I'm not quite sure about the coins. I think the person asking a question was from Canada, and I think the largest coins you have are 28 millimeters, but I'm gonna make this 30 in this direction. And here I'm gonna overbuild it, so I'm gonna make it 20. I'm gonna turn on a little body. I'm gonna finish sketch. E for extrude. The profile gets selected. I want to make it symmetric, both side, and a fairly bit. What's the coin? I think the largest width of a coin the Canadians had, I think they say, is 2.5. It's approximately 2 millimeters. I'm gonna make it 2.5. You can make it, or let's make it 3 millimeters. We're gonna put in some really big money here, like that. I'm gonna do a cut. I hit OK, and I go to my sketches and hide the sketch. So step one, we made that cut. Oh, that's a big one. We're gonna go back. I think I'm just simply gonna make it 2.5. Yeah, that looks better. We can of course now apply fillets, chamfers, whatever we want to. Not all the edges, sometimes it might fail because we have these little strange things that you can play around. So we get a slot. Now we want to make the opening at the bottom. Here, go look at this design. Looks like that. Look good. We're gonna create a sketch. Select the bottom plane here. Gonna hide the region. Hit P for project, and we have one single flat face. So I will project all of this face and hit OK and hide the body. This is just a lot of line which I'm just using for reference. I'm gonna make mark out of them and turn them into construction. This removes the profile. I want to somehow here put a round circle. So I'm gonna do a circle. I'm gonna do a 3-point circle. One of the points I'm gonna select is this one here. And I'm gonna do over here and somewhere over. I want to avoid constraints for now. I simply want it like that. So it's connected to there and this out here. And I'm gonna do tangent between this and here and this and here. And have a fully defined circle. Very nice. What I'm doing to start off now, because I have a lot of strange small faces on the inside of a shell, and I would like to add some geometry that I know are straight. So I'm gonna finish, wait for a model to think. We're gonna do an extrude of this circle. I'm gonna turn on the body, I'm gonna turn on my section analyzer, I can see things. I think I will make this 6 millimeters, and I'm gonna turn it into a join. So by doing this, I get some nice straight geometry. Wait, I can then now keep on working with. It's gonna hit OK. Nothing strange about that. Gonna hide that sketch. I'm gonna create a new sketch on this plane here. So now looking from the side, I think I'll turn on that sketch again if I'm gonna use some parts of it. I will do S and do an intersection because I want the width of this circle. For reference, can I do that? Select geometry, this circle. I'm gonna turn on the body and hit P for project once again. Can I select? I select the top face of the circle here, of a cylinder. Hit OK. Gonna hide it, so that's good. Hide the other sketch. I'm just gonna fill in the rest of this here. And be a bit careful. This little region point here is not the midpoint. So we're gonna make a line in the midpoint, in the center of this part here. And I'm gonna turn that into a center line. I do a line, yes. We do a line somewhere here. We do a line from the midpoint, somewhere up here. Midpoint, somewhere down here. And then a line from here to here. Now, all of these lines will not be used. So will be used, but they will not be used as part of profile. So this here, I'm gonna turn into construction. this here I will turn into construction, and then I'll make this horizontal like that. That means this moves together. So the last thing I want to do, I want a dimension from, sorry, D for dimension from here to here. And let's see, let's, can we do a 28? I think the largest coin still in Canada is 20 millimeters. There will be some more space because we were cut later, but we'll do it like this. And I will finish sketch. Turn on the body so we can have a look. That is good. S of the keyboard, we're going to use revolve command. I already placed it here, or you type in revolve, or you find it in the toolbar, or you find under create. You can see you can find the tool in a lot of places. S, revolve, and I'm going to use this profile, and like that it does the spinning around. So I hit OK, but I'm pleased with that. What this creates is a cutout with 45 degree, oops, sorry, I'm going to move around. Oh, I don't have my space mouse connected. So this is easy to print because we have 45 degree draft angles everywhere. We do not have any overhangs. I try to avoid that when I design. So we basically now have made the part we need here. But I will keep on working. And I might pop things into components already, but I'll keep working. But now I will still do another revolve. I will now create the part we need in here, the center plop or plug or whatever you call it. I hit OK, new body, OK, so it doesn't connect. We now have two bodies, visually here. I will do some more things to this, but to keep things simple, I want to add some clearance. I try with 0.1 millimeter, that told me the total clearance becomes 0.2, because I will make an offset of the face here. So we're going to make it a bit smaller, because I test printed that and it worked out. So the good thing, I will play the offset face to this small body. That means we can print the large body. And if things doesn't work out, sorry for that, if things doesn't work out, I can simply only redesign this small body. So, S on the keyboard, offset face. These two faces are the two that are in connection to the large body. So go with -0.05. Okay, turn off the body. We can have a look. We can see there's a small clearance between the bodies. So that's what I wanted. I'm going to hide the large one. I'm going to create a sketch. It's going to create it from the top of it. It's a bit easier. So we're going to create a sketch on top of this body. Let's have a look how things get turned around so we don't get confused. Our part is in that direction. Shall we do, yeah, we can do the slot in this direction. So I'm going to do a P of a keyboard. You can see the radius is not the center of the circle of the cylinder. So we're going to project in that. Hide the body. Going to make some lines. I'm going to make one line here. I'm going to make one line. Let's do it. Something like this. And I'm simply going to make one line here, up to here, and use a midpoint constraint between this and the center of the circle. Not the origin point, sorry. Almost clicked the wrong one. I'm going to mark this line and turn it into construction. So by this, we only have one degree of freedom this way. So we're going to dimension that. Dimension this line. And let's do it 11 millimeters. And let's see if I turn on this body and I turn on we can do slicing, we can do like that, so we can see things. I made a small mistake here. I need to project. Let's do that. Sorry, I'm going to redo things. I will delete these lines here. Sorry, I will delete this, and I need to project the outside too. Let's do a slice again so we can see things. P for project. I want to project in also the outer edge of this one, like that. Let's see if we hide. You got two circles very narrow to each other, so we need to keep things correctly here. Now I'm going to do a line, and that's going to be all the way from out here all the way. Let's move over. We need to redo things when I do mistakes. Not that one, we want it to that. You see it snapped to the first circle. No, we want the outer circle. Do another line somewhere up here, outer circle. Let's move out, zoom in, find the outer circle like that. Have a look. We have a horizontal constraint and we have a parallel constraint, and we could do a line from midpoint to midpoint. switch that line to construction geometry, midpoint between that one and that one. And that, going to dimension this. Let's do it 11 again. And I need one more projection. Going to turn on the small body. P for project. I want to have this here. I will not touch the bottom cone here. That will stay, that covers the hole, but I need to cut this into two teeth so that can intersect with the body. So I'm going to project in that. So by doing that, I should have everything I need. Yes. Let's start by editing or cutting away on this little plop or plug. I'm going to E for extrude. And we can select this here. And this here. Now I don't need to select the outer here, because if I select this here is outside of this face, and I can't use distance to object, because I want to select this object. Why doesn't it like my, did I select too much? Did I select too much somewhere? Can I do this face instead? Oh, sorry. Select this face. That works. Sometimes you have to select this face or that face or some other face, because you can get confused. But the important thing is the sketch cannot be outside of a boundary of things. So by doing that, I selected the bottom of this cone. I can cut away that. As you can see, I'm just working my way through this model, so I will be making mistakes. So we made this little plug thing. Now we want to cut this also away from this here. And I have problems seeing things, so we're gonna need an one more section analysis. So we're gonna do this, gonna move it up so we can see things. Hit OK. Makes things easier to see. Now we're gonna extrude once again. We're gonna select these two profiles. I'm gonna hide the body so we can see things. These two profiles. No, sorry, not those. I need to extrude that and this little small part out here. And that, do we have two profiles? Yes, we're going to move over to the other side. This profile and this profile. And turn on our body. And now, distance to objects. I'm going to cut all the way down to the bottom. Like that. Hit OK. Hide our sketch. Turn on our first body. Turn on the section analysis. And let's turn on this. And if we have a look, we now have a plug. But it has a small tooth here that goes through that little, let's hide the body. You have openings, so you can slide it up, and then you can rotate it and lock it in place. So it's just simple friction locking. So the important thing is here, yes, as I said, I did a 0.05 clearance here. It's done with the offset face here. If you want to change that, you go back and change that. And I like to do one more thing. I'm going to turn off that body. And can turn off that for now. Create a sketch on that plane. I will project in geometry. Yes, the bottom face here. Gonna project in and can project in the top face too. If I can get there. Here's the interesting thing. I'm gonna create the levels. You can see we get two lines. So we're gonna have a look at that. Sometimes when you project, you can see there's a bit of a thicker line here. We have two lines here. So I'm gonna hold down. I don't want duplicate lines, so I'm going to hold down the mouse button left and see if I can select the correct one. It should be that one. I hit delete. And there's still a line there. Delete that. Oh, it's split up into two lines. Okay. I'm going to add my own line here. I only want single line or always on this, so I don't get duplicate lines. I'm going to make a line from midpoint here to midpoint here. S on the keyboard, I simply have an arc command here. I'm going to do a 3-point arc. So I'm going to start here to here, pull up arc, use a midpoint, or constraint. Going to hold down and I want to find the midpoint of this arc. I'm holding down shift, find the midpoint and locking that into that one. These lines, of course, I can hit X on the keyboard to turn into construction geometry. And now I can dimension the depth of this cut. So I'm dimension it from here up to here. I want to leave 2 millimeters material. And I can dimension this slot here. I want to dimension it from here to here. Let's do that 18. Like that. I will finish sketch. Turn on the body. Do an extrude of that profile. I will make it symmetric. Full distance, let's make it 3 millimeters. Remember 3 millimeters. Gonna hit OK, hide the sketch. And we're gonna do a chamfer. We can do it from the modify menu, chamfer. And I'm gonna select this edge and this edge and use 3 as for earlier. And sorry, 3 divided by 2 or 1.5. We want to do that. So I do half of the width as a chamfer. This makes all the faces here 45 degrees, a bit easier to 3D print. Hit OK. And turn on this. And by doing this, I have now made the parts I want to make. For keeping things a bit, I've not made these components from the beginning because I start with STL, but if I want to, I can right click and create component from body. Split things into two components can sometimes be easier because now I can use the color coding, shift N to turn on the colors for components and have a look what things look like. It makes it sometimes a bit easier to see where things are. So here you can see my little slot where you can do something to turn this around and you can see things. So this is how I would take a low poly STL of a Pokemon in this face, in this case, and turn it into a piggy bank and use some of the mesh features. I hope you have learned something and hope to see you around. Take care and goodbye.